The world of crime isn't for the faint of heart, but for Siskiyou County native George Collord, it can also be a source of artistic inspiration.
There's always this part of me that's going, wow, you know, this is good stuff. You know, this is something that if we could just add some fictional characters in here and jazz it up a little bit, and it would be very readable for people.
The retired police officer turned novelist recently penned a crime thriller novel called Hear the Wind Blow.
I actually took that photograph, and that's real crime scene tape that I kept over from the old days.
The story follows a former homicide detective investigating a cold case who's exposed to the dangers of organized crime and prison gangs.
To rise up in any of those organizations, you have to be ruthless, cunning, smart, tough, deadly, brutal.
Collard, who now volunteers as a teaching assistant at a Mount Shasta elementary school, spent over 22 years in law enforcement, specializing in the investigations of street and prison gangs. He later became a deputy U.S. Marshal assigned to the FBI, interviewing dozens of current and former members of the notorious Hispanic prison gang called the Nuestra Familia.
Men who survive in that prison atmosphere, they have antenna that is so well defined. And they know right off the bat if you are genuine or not.
That authenticity is something he wanted to be sure to capture in his characters.
Everyone that I wanted to put in this book were compilations of folks that I knew, that I'd met along the way, whether they'd been policemen, whether they'd been trainers, whether they had been sources that I had recruited in Pelican Bay State Prison or in Folsom or in San Quentin.
Although Collard since moved from high-speed chases to grading papers.
All right, eight times eight.
He can relive the excitement of his crime-fighting days in the pages of his book, and now you can too.
You can't get it out of your blood. There's just something about it. To experience it is just, I was so lucky.
In Mount Shasta, Amanda Rose, Fox 26 News.